And I'm going to let you know right now, if you don't have Jesus Christ, man, I'm telling you, you won't be able to live without him. You just tuned into Carolina Urban Radio. I'm yours truly, Stanley Wilson Media, also known as Prophet Stanley Wilson, here in Jacksonville, North Carolina, 28540. Listen, Bishop will be calling in roughly around 10:30 tonight. But before he calls in, let's get into a little bit of the weather. Today was 92 degrees. Tonight will be 75. And on your Thursday, which is tomorrow, will be 92 degrees here in Jacksonville, North Carolina. And your low 74. And for your Friday, it will be high 82, low 69 with scattered showers. For your Saturday, will be cloudy, high 85, low 68 degrees. And last but not least, for your Sunday, high of 87, partly sunny, no rain whatsoever, low 68 degrees. Here in Jacksonville, North Carolina, 28540. Stand up. We be back right after this. Special guest on the line, folks, tonight. Great show tonight. Listen, we have a special guest on the line by the name of First Lady Joy Noel out of Virginia, I believe. First Lady, are you there?
I am here.
How you doing, woman of God?
I am doing very well, sir. How are you?
I'm blessed of the Lord. I'm going to be deep tonight. I'm going to say highly favored.
Amen.
So listen, woman of God, let our listening audience know, you know, where you're at and where you're calling from and what you do.
I am out of Waynesboro, Virginia, and I am the first lady of the Deliverance Tabernacle Ministry, where my husband Alex Norwell is pastor and founder. And I work for the University of Virginia in communications, and I love to sing, I love to praise and worship our awesome God.
Amen. That's a blessing. That's a blessing. Hey, First Lady, just real quick, how long have you been, like, you know, in ministry and in music and different things like that nature?
Well, I started singing in a youth choir at the age of 5, but I had my first solo experience at the age of 12, and I've been singing ever since.
Wow. Was your first song This Little Light of Mine?
It was actually Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace.
I did it in a gospel play that our organization, our church organization had started. And so that was my very first solo song.
Wow, that is bananas. Listen, per our last conversation, woman of God, I do know that you've just finished releasing a single. You want to tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure, absolutely. The name of the single is I Am More. It's just to encourage our men and women and young people in God that you are more. You're more than your mistakes. You're more than what you've done in your past. God has a greater calling and a purpose for your life, and it just to push you to get to that destined place in God. So it's definitely an encouragement for the believers of Christ that no matter what you've done, no matter what you've gone through, you are more than those things.
Wow, that is a blessing. I like that. I like that. Do you have any kids, First Lady?
I have 3. I have a daughter who's 16. I have a son who's 13, and I have a son who's 5.
Okay. I thought I was doing bad now. I got 2. I got a 7-year-old and I got a 1-year-old. But listen, First Lady, we're going to go ahead and play this single. And what is the name of it again? I Am More, right?
It is I Am More.
Now listen, how can they get their hands on this this CD of yours, and how can they book you and different things like that? I tell you what we're going to do. After the single is over with, what we're going to do is we're going to have you back on the line, and we're going to ask that you get yourself together, you know, with all your information, and let the people know how they can contact you and get in contact with you and book you.
Absolutely. Sounds great.
All right, folks, this is I Am More right here on Carolina Urban Radio WCUR.
You see, I am more than I believe. God made me your promise to succeed. I am more, yes, I am more. And I am more than my mistakes. I am more, my past been erased. God's given me the victory. I am more, yes, I am more.
Oh, my goodness. Now, that is a CD. First Lady, what's up, woman of God? What? That was the bomb.
Thank you so much.
Man, yo, I was sitting here in the studio just jamming. I was like, oh, man. How long has this CD's been out, this single's been out?
It just dropped on Tuesday.
All right, now this is what I want you to do, woman of God. Now, I want you to give your numbers out. How can they book you? And your Facebook, your Instagram, Twitter. Let them know. And I want you to repeat every last one of them twice, nice and slow. See, now what a lot of radio stations do, they be like, well, give us a call, 1-800-377-5520, 1-800, you know what I'm saying? You know, nah. You know, people can't get that. So I want you to repeat it nice and slowly. Give them all of your information. Listen, people of God, if you're out there, I'm not going to say if you're out there because we got thousands of people listening tonight. But I want you to get your pens and paper ready. Now, we want to help this woman of God. When she gives you her information, you need to contact her on Facebook. Tell her, listen, we heard you off of Carolina Urban Radio. Encourage her. Let her know that you're out there, that you heard her music, her CD, and that you love it. Give her some encouragement, people of God. All of my listeners, I'm letting you know right now. Come on now. All right? The radio stations in New York City, you already know what it is. Let's give this woman of God some encouragement. Go grab a pen and paper, folks, right now. Come on, come on. I'm going to give you about 30 seconds to go run and get a pencil and paper and to write down this woman of God information. And she's also a preacher. First Lady, invite her out to come preach. Invite her out to come minister. I know, shy. But nevertheless, woman of God, go ahead and give your information how they can get in contact with you. And say it nice and slow for them.
Yes, sir. To book me, you can email me at joynoelbooking@gmail.com. Again, that is joynoelbooking@gmail.com.
joynoelbooking@gmail.com, correct? Joy Noel Bookings or Booking?
Booking@gmail.com.
Folks, write that down. All right, I'm giving some time to write it down because we really want to push this woman of God. Go ahead, woman of God.
You can look me up on Facebook at Joy Noel. Joy Noel, simply JoyNoell. I am on Instagram at Songbird Joy, SONGBIRD Joy. I am on Twitter at Songbird Joy, but it's SONG. BYRDJOY.
That's what's up. Now, woman of God, repeat. You kind of broken up a little bit on the Facebook page and your IG. Let's focus really on that as well for those that are listening on social media. Go ahead and repeat that for your Facebook and your IG.
Facebook, I am at Joy Noel. That's my name, JoyNoell. Instagram, I am Songbird Joy. That is SONGBIRDJOY.
That's what's up. You got it, folks. Right here, WCUR, Carolina Urban Radio. Woman of God, thank you so very much for calling in. Listen, you have any concerts coming up, or your church, your location of your church, your address? Give that out and the time and all that good stuff.
Absolutely. We are Deliverance Tabernacle Ministries, again, out of Waynesboro, Virginia. Our address is 401 North Poplar, P-O-P-L-A-R Avenue, Suite D, Waynesboro, Virginia, 22980. We have morning worship beginning at 30 every Sunday. Bible studies at 6:30, and our prayer is at 6:30, and our Bible study starts at 7. So come on out if you need a place to worship.
Come on out if you need a place of worship, deliverance, healed. You know, if you run your mouth so much, you know, you need deliverance from talking so
all
much.
All that good stuff.
All that real good stuff. Lord, I mean, you know what? Back in the days, I'm from New York City, Queens, and Brooklyn, New York, and I came up from, underneath some great leaders, man. And, we need some real true deliverance. I mean, when people start talking, you just shut up in Jesus' name.
I know that's right.
Yeah, I know. But nevertheless, woman of God, thank you so very much. Do you have anything else to tell the listening audience tonight?
It was my pleasure. Go out and grab it. I'm on iTunes. I'm on Google Play. I'm on Amazon Music and also on CD Baby. So go out and grab a copy and support Kingdom Music.
That's right. Kingdom Music, WCUR, Carolina Bay Radio, live in effect. We'll be back with some more great music right after this. Woman of God, please hold and we'll get back to you. WCUR live in effect. We'll be back to you right after this. The next voice you hear will be Mr. Bishop Dr. Milton. World Without Walls.
So amazing, so amazing. Your love for us is overwhelming. How awesome is our God? So amazing, so amazing. Is overwhelming. How awesome is our God.
That's right, Carolina Bay Radio. I'm yours truly, Stanley Wilson, media doing it to you live in your eardrum, as also known as Prophet Stanley Wilson, WCUR, broadcasting live from Jacksonville, North Carolina, 2550. Thank you so, so very much for tuning and listening again here tonight. Listen, folks, great show for you tonight. On the line, we have a great man of God by the name of Bishop Milton out of Hempstead, North Carolina, and also Raleigh, North Carolina. Bishop, are you there?
Bishop is right here.
What's going on, man?
How's it going?
I'm doing well, Doc. I can't complain. I'm extremely excited, Doc, to have you on tonight with me.
Yes, sir. I'm excited to be here with you on Carolina Urban Radio. Yes.
Hey, we got to turn all the way up. Man, we got... I'm sorry?
Yes,
sir. I'm sorry. I cut you off. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, go ahead, sir.
No, what I was saying is, man, we got, man, countries all over the world right now listening to you, man. We got people here in Virginia, North Carolina listening to you live, man. I make sure me to have you, man, as one of the bishops, man, and just as a good friend also as well.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I am equally excited to be on tonight and to share with the wonderful listeners from all over the country. I am excited to be here, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Listen, Bishop, just real quick, man, for about 10 to 15 minutes. Man, let's get into a little bit of encouragement, man, for some of these people, man. Because some of the people that are listening online tonight need it. They want that encouragement. They're thirsty tonight, man. So I'm gonna give you a little leeway, man, and just introduce yourself and where you're from, and just get into whatever God tells you to do.
Yes, sir. Well, to the listening audience, I am Bishop Christopher Milton out of Jacksonville, Wilmington, North Carolina, and we are the pastor of the Will Without Walls there. And tonight, I just want to come on and just share with everyone and just speak into your lives and speak into your situation. And, you know, I was thinking all day, you know, what will I speak about tonight? And one thing that the Lord just kind of laid on my heart to share with our listening audience tonight, it comes from Isaiah chapter 41. And I'm finding that this is a time of year, again, that we are seeing a lot of people discouraged and a lot of people operating in fear. And when we operate in fear and we allow fear to arrest us and fear to completely infiltrate our lives, it causes all types of things to happen to us. And so I really want to talk tonight about that fear. You know, some of us are afraid of being alone. We're afraid of what's going to happen with our livelihood, with our well-being, with our jobs, or in relationships, you know, operating in fear. But Isaiah 41 and 10 says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, and I will uphold you with my righteousness." And here the prophet is just speaking to us, and again, he's speaking to us in that place of fear that many of us operate in. And one thing that I like to say, and I use this as a mantra in my life, that there's a thin line between fear and wisdom. Both fear and wisdom take experiences that we've been through before, things that we've encountered, but fear says, I'll never do it again, while wisdom says, I'll never do it the same way again. And so tonight, I really want us to begin to operate in the wisdom of God and see ourselves saying, hey, it may not have worked right for me the first time around. It may not have went the way that I wanted it to. But again, tonight I am embracing my opportunity to be the will of God and to walk in the fullness of the will of God and not be arrested by fear. You know, Prophet Stanley, I've found that this is the time where so many people are going through so much, and the strong man, again, as I said earlier, in their life, is fear. And I found even now that even the spirit of suicide is just so rampant, and people are taking their own lives, and they're doing this because they're afraid.
That's right.
They're afraid of failure, Prophet. They're afraid of, you know, what's going to happen if things don't work out for me. And I believe that as men of God, as the light in the kingdom, we need to encourage God that, hey, this fear that you're having, and this fear that translates into wanting to end everything and throw in the towel. I can't take it anymore. I believe tonight that God is speaking to us, and he's saying the first thing that we have to do, number one, before we can overcome, before we can be victorious, prophet, is get rid of the spirit of fear.
Wow, that's deep. You know,
man, and I'm finding that a lot of times we operate in anger because we are afraid. We operate in retaliation, and we operate in so many different ways because we are afraid. I was asking God, I said, God, what is it tonight that you would have me to talk about? And he said to me, it's time that we would have a genocide on suicide. It's time now that we would show the people of God, show people from all over that are hurting, that are broken, that feel like no one understands, those that are home alone in midnight hour feeling like if I ended it, no one would care. Tonight, from this platform, I want to speak encouragement to you. I want to tell you that that spirit of fear that we are operating in is causing us to make decisions that are not at our best interest. It's causing us to be discouraged and operate in depression. But tonight, when the Lord says, fear not, he's not saying simply don't fear. He's saying, I'm going to tell you why not to fear, because I am with you. You know, Prophet, a lot of times we see ourselves and we feel alone. We feel that no one understands us. That place within itself is a difficult place to be. But tonight, God is saying, hey, the reason I don't want you to fear is because I'm with you. You know, you may feel alone, but never be afraid to trust that unknown future to a known God. And there's people right now, Prophet, that's on this line listening to us that may have contemplated ending, contemplated throwing in the towel, contemplated saying, hey, I really don't want to live, but I can't share it with anyone because I'm a Christian. I can't share it with anyone because I'm saved and I'm not supposed to feel this way. But tonight, I want you to know that God says that he's come that you might have life, and that more abundantly. And tonight, I want you to begin to wake up to the fact that no matter what you've been through, no matter what you dealt with, no matter what you're walking through right now, that God says, fear not, I am with you. And when we really embrace the fact that God is with us, then his strength can come and begin to gird us up. He's saying to us tonight that if we'll come out of the fear, if we'll come out of the place of thinking that God's arms are too short, and you know, I'm operating in the spirit of shame and condemnation. I can't share with anyone where I'm really at tonight. Every one of our listeners, God wants you to know that he hears your prayer.
That's right.
He hears your cry. And even though you feel alone in this place, God is saying, don't fear, because I'm with you. Somebody that may be thinking about ending it even tonight, some of you may have been considering that. And I found that there's so many people in this hour that just feels like life is too much. They feel like they just can't take it anymore. But that's a trick of the enemy, because God is a present help in the time of trouble. And so the thing that he's saying to us tonight, Prophet, is I don't want you to fear because I'm with you. But then he says, be not dismayed, for I am your God. The problem with a lot of us is that we have other gods in our lives. You know, we have idols. We've created idols out of certain situations. And when we make those things and those people and those scenarios our God, we find ourselves being in a position where we can't really embrace the truth of God's will because we have other gods. And now tonight, we must come back before God and say, God, hey, I put this person before you. I put this situation before you. I put this circumstance before you. But tonight, I must dethrone every idol because I need you to uphold me with your righteous hand. And so tonight, I want to encourage that person that's saying, God, if I ended it, I know I can't take it anymore. God, if I ended it, I would be losing this, losing that. And tonight, that person that is thinking, I don't know which way to turn. I don't know which way to go.
I don't know what to do from here. God is speaking to you tonight saying that I am here to help you. Don't be afraid of what they've done, what has happened, what people think. And tonight, I want to encourage you, reach out. Reach out to someone for help. Reach out to someone and say, hey, I'm having some very negative thoughts. I feel like ignorant. I can't take it anymore. There's destiny inside of you. And don't allow these temporary feelings. And they come and they go. I know you may have times when you're having pleasant thoughts. And then all of a sudden, these negative imaginations kick back in and say, hey, you might as well end it. You can't take it anymore. But tonight, we're going to cast out every imagination prophet that exalts itself against the will of God. And I'm speaking to you tonight, those that are in the listening audience, that are really in that place that are saying, I just have come to my wit's end. I've done all I can do. God is a present help, and he's strengthening you right now. Someone right now, you may need to fall on your face and throw your hands up and surrender your situation to God and say to God, I can't do it. I can't fix it, but I know that you can. I know that you can bring me through this. So tonight, people of God, understand, number one, God wants you to release that spirit of fear. Let it go. Don't operate in the fear of what could happen, in the fear of yesterday, in the fear of your pain. But know that God's saying, I am with you. And then understanding past that, he's saying, don't even allow yourself to be dismayed, discouraged, oppressed. Don't allow yourself to be in that place where you can't sleep at night without taking sleeping medications because your mind is so troubled. Finding yourself in that place where you don't have joy. You're not smiling anymore. Slowly but surely, you're thinking that your situation is out of control. Tonight, God wants you to know that he loves you wherever you are. He died for you wherever you are. And that there's purpose inside you and that you don't have to give yourself over to quit, to giving it all up, to ending it all. And I know some of you may be saying, Bishop, this is a very controversial issue that you're choosing to bring up on the radio show tonight. But I'm bringing it up, Prophet, because there's so many people that have been plagued with this spirit of suicide that want to give up, want to throw in the towel. And because we have a platform tonight, I wanted to take this time tonight and give the hopeless hope, give the broken opportunity to even be healed. So I want you to hold on to that scripture, Prophet. And that's the main thing that I want to share with our listening body tonight, that, hey, fear not. God is with you. Be not dismayed. And don't allow fear. Somebody may have lost their job. You're wondering, how am I going to take care of my family? Someone else may have the fear of losing a loved one that may be sick, a loved one that may be in a relationship with you. How, you know, what can I do at this point? You know, and I don't know, Prophet, I don't know if we can take calls tonight. If someone wants to call in and say, hey, Bishop, this is where I'm at. This is what I've been dealing with. We are here for you tonight. And again, hold on to the fact that God has not brought you this far to leave you, and understanding that he is saying to you tonight that the fear that we've been operating in fear paralyzes. Fear causes us to be in a place where we can't mobilize. We can't move to our dreams. We can't do what's next because of past failure. But we must understand that there's no leader that has never made mistakes. And sometimes we got to understand the mistakes we make us. And I want to close with one last scripture. And it's Psalm 34:17-20. And it says, when the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their trouble. The Lord is near the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones, and not one of them will be broken. So tonight again, the main thing that I really, really want you to embrace is that God is saying, you don't have to operate in fear any longer. Thank you, Father.
Yes, sir. Man of God, that was, woof. Oh, man, wow. That was amazing, Doc. That was amazing. We have Miss Tiffany out of Los Angeles, California. She wanted to know where the church is located. She says she'll be in North Carolina in a couple of weeks. If you want to give out that information, Doc.
Sure. We are located. We are one church in two locations. It depends on when you're coming in. On first and third Sunday, we are in Hempstead, North Carolina. The address is 14840 Highway 17, Hempstead, North Carolina, 28443. Our location for Raleigh on second and fourth Sunday is 241 Horizon Drive, Raleigh, North Carolina. Also, you can check us out on the web. And our church web address is www.thewellwow, and that's thewellwow.org. And personally, you can reach me at www.christopherpaul.org.
You heard it right here live on WCUR on Carolina Urban Radio. I'm yours truly, Stanley Wilson Media. Folks, I hope you wrote this down, man. Get in contact with this man of God. I mean, you just don't know. Right here, WCUR on Carolina Urban Radio. I'm yours truly, Bishop. Thank you so very much, sir. If you don't mind holding, and we'll get right back to you. Right here, WCUR on Carolina Urban Radio, Miss Jacqueline Carr, it's going to happen.
You got to see it before it happens. Believe before it happens. Receive before it happens. You got to know it's gonna happen. Though it seems it won't be, but God said this one's on me. I know it's hard to see, but God said this one's on me. Before it happens, it's gonna happen. But God says, sometimes it's hard to see, but oh, God says, hold me. Gotta see it before it happens. Believe before it happens. See before it happens. You got to know.
That's right. It's going to happen right here at WCUR Carolina Bay Radio. I'm yours truly, Prophet Stanley Wilson, doing it to your lap and your eardrum. That's right. Listen, folks, it's about that time for me to take up my toys and get up out of here. But before I do, I'd like to give you some information. If you have not already requested me or connected with me on our social media networks, go ahead and request me on Facebook underneath Stanley Wilson Media. Once again, that's Stanley Wilson Media on Facebook. Once again, for your listening pleasure, that's Stanley Wilson Media on Facebook. Also, like our radio station Facebook page underneath Carolina Urban Radio. Once again, that's Carolina Urban Radio. Also, connect with me on Instagram underneath radio underscore producer on Instagram. Once again, that's radio underscore producer on Instagram, which you guys call IG. But once again, thank you so very much for tuning and listening to, that's right, WCUR Gospel After Dark, right here with Prophet Stanley Wilson. We'll be back on the air next week at 10 p.m. That's right, with some more great people and women of God from all over the world. Once again, thank you once again. If you'd like to get in contact with us here at our office, you can contact us at 910-378-5848. Once again, 910-378-5848. We're going to take you out with I Am More right here on WCUR. Good night. That's right. Connect with Prophet Stanley Wilson on Facebook underneath Stanley Wilson Media. That's right, Stanley Wilson Media on Facebook. Once again, Stanley Wilson Media on Facebook. Go right ahead and request us live right now. On Instagram, request us underneath radio_producer. Once again, radio_producer on Facebook. As always, thank you so very much for tuning in live. I'm yours truly, Stanley Wilson Media, known as Prophet Wilson. Good night. You just tuned in to the hottest radio station in Eastern Carolina, CarolinaUrbanRadio.com, playing you the best in hip-hop and R&B.
See me through, leaving that thing. hear somebody out there saying, I need God in my house.
Lord, I saw your face last night when I looked in the sky. You were smiling. You told me it would be okay. You would make a way in my dark times. Every time I hear your voice, and every time I feel your touch, lets me know that I can face tomorrow one more time. When all my friends go away, I'll be glad to say you're still near me. Even when the winter blows by, I feel warm. So lovely, you. Every time I hear your voice, and every time I feel your touch, lets me know that I
said it. I know I did it. Maybe I went overboard to prove a point. But sometimes my pride gets in the way. Maybe I need some time away to get my head together. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe this was my life.
Showed me it never seemed that I would listen to anything, but you've got my attention more than you know. I took it in, I dealt with it, but I waited too late to use it.
Maybe this was my last chance.
I may never. Because you made me understand.
I'm so sorry that I chose to walk away from you.
I'm so sorry.
And I'm sorry if I turned your love away.
I didn't mean to take
your words. I didn't mean to take your words. Whoa, and make them seem so
try sincerely.
Back again.
I never ever wanted
to burn this way.
If I-
and we declare you are the only living God.
Take away my impurity. got the best of me, yeah. And I gotta do something quick before I go crazy. Too many voices in my head so loud I can't even think. My friends and family are gone. My life is going so wrong. Lord, I need you to come. Oh, take me home. Oh, make a way out of no way. My hero, come on and save the day.
Never lose it. much I've let you down. I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow.